Legion number one. I'm Reverend Marcus Lyle, and I work here at Brooksby Village as an interfaith chaplain and minister. I'm so excited to be able to look out and see a full chapel tonight. Tonight's free concert is sponsored by Eastern Bank for the third holiday season. And I'd like to thank Eastern Bank manager Rosalind Porcione, who's been responsible. Thanks a lot for that. I know, though, I heard there were lines on Monday morning, and the tickets went in less than 3 hours. So there were a lot of residents who made the trip all the way over here to just be disappointed. So please spread the word to your neighbors that, thanks to Bert Bartsoff, that tonight's concert is being recorded for Brooksby TV, and we'll broadcast it later this week. Yeah. And now I'm going to pass the mic on to our evening's MC, Don St. Marie.
Thank you, Mark. It's a pleasure for the Merrimack Valley Concert Band to be here, as it is every year. It's a beautiful facility to listen to music in. So, without further ado, here is the Merrimack Valley Concert Band under the direction of Tony Beavers.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
And as we have every year, popular request, presented to you as we end the first half of our show with a poem by Clement Clark Moore, "'Twas the Night Before Christmas." The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. The children were all nestled, all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. Just settled down for a long winter's nap. When out on the lawn there arose such a clatter, I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter. The moon on the breast of the new-fallen snow gave the luster of midday to objects below. When what to my wondering eyes should appear but a miniature sleigh and eight tiny reindeer. With a little old driver so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be St. Nick. Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer and Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Dunder and Blitzen. To the top of the porch, to the top of the wall, now dash away, dash away, dash away all. As dry leaves that before the wild hurricane fly, when they meet with an obstacle, mount to the sky. So up to the housetop, the coursers they flew, with a sleigh full of toys, and St. Nicholas too. And then, in a twinkling, I heard on the roof the prancing and plying of each little hoof. As I drew in my head and was turning around, down the chimney St. Nicholas came with a bound. He was dressed all in fur, from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his pack. His eyes, how they twinkled. His dimples, how merry. His cheeks were like roses. His nose like a cherry. His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow. And the beard of his chin was as white as the snow. The stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke it encircled his head like a wreath. He had a broad face and a little round belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly. He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf. And I laughed when I saw him, in spite of myself. A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread. He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work and filled all the stockings, and then turned with a jerk, and laying his finger aside of his nose, and giving a nod, off the chimney he rose. He sprang to his sleigh, to his team gave a whistle, and away they all flew like the down of a thistle. Ere he drove out of sight, happy Christmas to all, and to all a good night.
Thank you. feeling in town. Normally, at this time, we have a sing-along, and I usually walk around with the microphone. Some of you may remember. And usually, if the people aren't looking at me, those are the few I choose to sing to the microphone.